Hello and welcome to Mysticraft. My name is Whisperfire, and as you could tell, I'm in the middle of a terraforming project. I've been working on flattening out this land. I've also been working on gathering sugarcane. And this farm it uses an observer and a simple redstone circuit. It's just really easy to make, and I've actually been kind of amused. You see, normally I don't pay attention to the enchant on vanilla tools, but this shovel right here has Mending 4, and it cuts through dirt like paper. Check this out. Oh yeah. This thing cuts through paper, cuts through dirt like it's nobody's business. So, I'm gonna go ahead and set up a camera account. As you could tell from this angle right over here, we got a camera account going, and we are going to get ready to do a third person time lapse. It's not much, it's just basically clearing out the land here. So, today's going to be a work day, nothing for a special build, but yeah, we're just going to get some progress done. It's been a while since we had a time lapse, so let's chat. Well, I'm getting used to playing vanilla. I'm so used to playing modded, and I heard through the grapevine that the developer from Forge says that the Forge equivalent for 1.13 is going to be a couple months away. So I'm willing to think that a lot of modded projects are going to be on hold, at least when it comes to converting to the new aquatic update. Anyway, so basically I've been sitting here and I've been shearing off the surface of the stone, and it's just been a long process trying to get the whole peninsula, you know, all tip-top ready for a build that I have no idea what I'm going to do with yet. I have a couple ideas bouncing around in my head, but I wanted to at least get a, you know, a clear, clean palette to get started with. So basically, I flattened out the land, and then I took the top layer of stone and then filled it up with dirt so that we can let the grass grow on it. And then, as a last step, I lit up the area because, well, you know, vanilla mobs, you know, mobs spawn and creepers be creeping and all that fun stuff. So anyway, we're almost done with this time lapse, so it was fun talking with you, and I am keeping an eye out for when updates for mods come out. Well, this project took about an hour. It wasn't too bad. And I've been gathering as much sugarcane as I can. It will be a while before the grass covers the dirt, but I think we got another project on our hands. You see, there's a reason why I've been collecting all the sugarcane that I possibly can. Because of all of the fishing that I have done, and I've done a lot of AFK fishing, been able to get a mending book. So, there are two villager farms, villager breeders, villager traders, so that we can go ahead and trade for emeralds and all that fun stuff. So, I'm just simply gonna sit here and wait. Will that thing pop up? Will it pop up? Ah, heck with it. Okay. So, let's go ahead and go down to our ender chest, because that's where I'm keeping the trade goods. So, I need to fix that. But anyway, we need to make as much paper as we can, and I think we have enough for another mending book. So far I got mending on my sword, my fortune pickaxe and my shovel. So we got a silk touch here, and it's just waiting for another enchantment. So let's just grab that and this. Okay, so let's see, how much paper do we get? I think this gives one paper per sugarcane, but you got to do it in a three at a time craft. But this is good, this is good. And I get a chance to show you where the villager trading centers are. Okay, so let's go ahead and pop that in there. Pop this in there. Yep. Okay. And one more. Okay. That should do it. So we'll just pop that there. Oh yeah, and I want to grab the item that I want to enchant next, which is my axe, because I want to farm wood. So let me go ahead, grab my axe, and I'll meet you at the first villager breeder and I'll show you around. Well, this is our first stop at Thingelkin Industries. This is actually the first villager breeder, and it's this portal back here. Just a moment, villager breeder. So this is one of them that's on the server, and I will show you around. Okay, so this is the breeder right here, and it looks like someone's up there doing some work. Bindoman. Okay, hi. All right, let's take a look. Now, there's a villager that's named. That's a mending villager, which is called Letitia, I believe? Oh, Leshwana. And if you take a look at the mending book, it is 34 emeralds. That is a bit pricey. Please excuse the sound. Okay, so that one is 34 paper. Right now, we are just interested in getting emeralds. Oh yeah, I named my sword a bad joke, just in case I kill someone with it for the lulz. Alright. Wow, 33 paper? Yeah, that's not so great. But I am in dire need of emeralds. Oop, got you traded out. Alright, let's grab some of that. Yeah, you're expensive. But I am going to trade out. Get all of the emeralds. Yeah, you make your happy sounds. Yep, you're done. Okay, and you? Okay, so we got 20 emeralds. Alright. 34. Maybe we can get... Yes. So far, so good. Okay. Oh, your trade's refreshed. That's good for you. Okay, so alright, so we got 31 emeralds. Okay, so we got our emeralds here. Now, I will show you where the other villager spawner is. I believe it was built by Fox and Tall Bunny, but I don't know of Tall Bunny's involvement on it. But anyway, we're going to be passing by the post office, so let me go ahead and run down here. I think I have a delivery in my box. I dropped off a bunch of name tags to Chibi Mango and said that pay me whatever she feels like. So maybe we can get a couple of diamonds or something like that. She said she didn't have much, but the name tags were really easy to come by. So I was willing to part with them cheap, just pretty much saying, name your own price. Hey, look, there's someone else up here. I think that's Kisari. That Kasari? Yes, it is. And yum. Tweak, torque, 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 torque. Okay, so we got something in our box. Oh, okay, so no emerald, no diamonds, but I'd be willing to accept this. This is pretty nice. Ooh, cake. Gotta have the cake. Okay, so let's go ahead and continue to the north tunnel, past this pigman, and this is a little bit of an exposed area, so don't worry. All right, villager farm. So this is the second villager farm. And I honestly feel that the trades are much better. But I wanted to use up all of the villager trades to get the emeralds. Because you know how villagers lock out on their trades. And there's just so many villagers, you know. So many librarians that you can trade paper with. But I think we have enough for 2 mending books. So let's take a look. Do not leave villager trades locked. Okay. So, this guy here. This guy has silk touch, I believe. Or something like that. And this guy has mending. Okay, so let's go ahead and go over to the mending. Yep. 12 books. All right. 12 emeralds. 1, 2. Check it out. We got 2 mending books. Okay. So let's hit the anvil. And let's take our efficiency and our mending. And we got 1 more tool. Now, where's the ender chest? Right here. Let's grab that. We'll pop this back. Pop this back. Pop that back. Alright. And then our silk touch is also going to have mending. So, there you go. Okay. So, let's go ahead. Okay, I got that silk touch. All right, the diamond axe. I'm going to leave that in there. Okay. Ooh, got east and west mixed up, and now I'm 3,000 blocks away from my base. Whoops. Okay, so we did not leave any villager trades locked. That's good. I was kind of afraid because we needed a boat ton of emeralds. So, all that's left is our armor. So, we need 5 more mending books. This will include an elytra that we don't yet have. But, I want to plan ahead and get an elytra, or a mending book for an elytra that I will eventually get. But as it is, right now, all of our tools have mending on it. So, we are slowly progressing and working our way towards getting the ultimate crafting tools. So, let me go ahead and run all the way back. Yep, run all the way back. And we'll see what else there is to do. I managed to get enough paper that I think I can squeeze just a couple more emeralds out of this villager. Because I think this is all I need to get my last mending book. Okay, so we got 6 mending books. Whew, that took a lot. I mean, that took about, I don't know, a day and a half. Oh, cool. His trades refreshed. Okay, so it saves me the trouble of having to do anything. That is good. Okay, so let's go ahead and dress up this equipment. Okay, so the helmet has unbreaking 3, respiration, and protection plus aqua affinity. And now it will have mending. Our chest has thorns, unbreaking, protection, and now mending. Now, leggings, well, that's not going to be too much. Okay, so this also has mending. Okay, 1 more. And we got Depth Strider. Alright. All of our gear everything has mending. Check that out. Plus, we have two additional books for an elytra and a trident, which I don't have. But we got everything. Oh my goodness. Now all we need to do is sit there and just repair our gear. Oh, that is good. Full mending gear. All right. So let me go ahead and show you the house. Show you the, I guess you can call it a peninsula. And see all of the terraforming that I've done on it. But I want to give a special shout out to Bendomon and Fox, because they were the ones who built the two villager breeders, which enabled all of the trades and enabled yours truly to have mending. So yeah. Oh yeah, also our pickaxe, the silk touch one, also has mending, so we are all set. Okay, so let me go ahead and show you the house, and I'll show you some of the materials that I gathered. So here is the peninsula. It is remarkably flat and the torches are oh so D. Yeah, I can words. Trust me, I can words today. All right, so I've been working on the pumpkins. I've been working on getting some pumpkin pie. And I was kind of thinking, if we have a shopping district, I should make a shop that sells pie and call it I Like Pie or something like that. I don't know. But I have been making concrete powder and putting it into water and getting this white concrete block. So I was thinking this would be the base material. The base material for our build. Because, well, I kind of like it. It's really nice. It is nice, uniform, and clean, and all that stuff, and it's good for a modern build. But I was thinking of a skyscraper build with its lower levels using the water elevator with the soul sand to go up and the magma cube to go straight down. And I was thinking, well, I don't think I have the clouds turned on, but have the main floor above the clouds and have like, let me see if I can build a rough draft of it. So, have the center part here and have it with just the water elevators. And then have it kind of going out in a circle. Kind of like this. Oops. Not quite what I expected. But, wow, I need to learn how to Minecraft. I need to learn how to vanilla. But I was thinking something a little bit round, kind of like this, up on top. We already got the floor lit up, so I was thinking of having like a sky type base with the water elevators. But I'm gonna need a lot of glass. That is going to take quite a bit. And that kind of looks derpy. But I miss Vainmire. But I'm still thinking about the design, and I'm thinking for wood, for the wood floors or wood accents, get dark oak. But I need to actually grow the dark oak. And also for trim, we can take advantage of the silk touch pickaxe and get some blocks of ice. And try that blue ice that's available that you use with packed ice. But yeah, I was thinking something like that. But anyway, we have accomplished two primary objectives. One, flatten out this land so that we can get it ready for a build. And two, gather up enough sugarcane so that we can get mending books and get all of our stuff mended. So anyway, that's about all the time that I have for this episode. I've been doing a lot of work. This took a lot of work. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed yourself, so be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share. This has been Whisperfire, and I wish you an awesome day. Oh yeah.